Hi everyone, in this video we're going to be talking about reversible chemical reactions and chemical equilibrium of a reaction. Let's just give a quick definition to start things off. A reversible reaction is a reaction in which the reactants are creating product and the products are creating reactants at a constant rate. We identify the equilibrium rate at which a reaction advances through a capital K equilibrium variable, known as the equilibrium reaction rate constant. However, just note that it is only constant as long as your system is isothermal, which means that the temperature is not changing with time. So, as we stated earlier, the reaction is proceeding in both the forward and reverse directions. Therefore, we can identify two separate reaction rate constants, one in the forward direction and then one in the reverse direction. So, if we are to understand the reaction rate of our reaction here, how do you think we would express that? Well, we could say that the production of one component in our reaction is equal to the production of said component minus the rate consuming that component. Therefore, we can write this as the reaction rate of this component is equal to the reverse reaction constant times some function that describes the rate of production of that reactant, which we will talk about more in a future video. Minus a similar term, but for the opposite. So our reaction constant in the forward direction times some function describing how much of a reactant is being consumed, times some function describing the concentration of a reactant. Remember that at equilibrium, it is not that we have no reactions occurring, it is just that we have a constant rate of production and a constant rate of consumption for a given molecule. This can be expressed using our equation from above like so. Therefore, we can find the equilibrium rate constant through a ratio of the concentration functions of the products to the reactants. We will talk more about the concentration functions of our other types of reactions in future videos. But specifically for reactions at equilibrium, we can use what is called the law of mass action. This relates the amount of each species we have within our system at equilibrium. This is what the law of mass action looks like. We have the concentrations of our products raised to their stoichiometric coefficients divided by the concentrations of our reactants raised to their stoichiometric coefficients. So, if we have 2A plus 2B is in equilibrium with 1C plus 2D, then we end up with the following equation. To build on this, we could be given concentrations for each of our molecular species, and could use this information to find the equilibrium constant. Alternatively, we could be given an equilibrium constant in all but one molecular concentrations, and from that, find our missing concentration. So now that we have an understanding of what reversible reactions look like, and how we could solve some problems using the information we now know about them, let's look at some actual reversible reactions. Here I've written out just a few reversible reactions. Just remember that in all of these reactions, the reactants are forming the product at a certain rate, and the products are forming the reactants at a certain rate. So, in this first reaction here, if we had more reactants than products had equilibrium, we would say that this reaction lies to the left. Just think that at equilibrium, you have a constant amount of reactant turning to product, and a constant amount of product turning into reactant. But these rates are not necessarily the same. Just both are constant and therefore at equilibrium. Thank you for checking out this video, and I hope it helped your understanding of reversible reactions. If you enjoyed, please like, subscribe, and consider checking out our Patreon page to support the channel. However, if you have any comments, questions, or concerns about the information I provided in this video, please leave a comment down below, and I will do my best to address your concerns.